all month long here on Shaw TV, we have been talking about foods and working out and staying physically active. We are wrapping up Nutrition Month here on Shaw TV. We've had dietitians in, and today Linda joins us now, a consulting dietitian. We want to kind of wrap up the month by talking, busting some of those myths people have about food and working out. And one of the common ones that I hear all the time, somebody starts working out and all of a sudden they think a magic supplement or a weight loss pill is what they need, not realizing that everything they need is at the grocery store. Food. So, first of all, what should people be thinking about when they're exercising?
Well, first of all, products like stimulants or weight loss and muscle building supplements are not needed to get the most out of your active lifestyle. Great tasting, healthy food to fuel up is the way to go. And following Canada's food guide is the easiest way that you can ensure you're getting all of the nutrients and energy that you need for your active lifestyle. The guide shows you how much you need to eat from every day from each food group. Vegetables and fruit, grain products, milk and alternatives provide carbohydrate to fuel your active muscles. Meat and alternatives and milk and alternatives provide high quality protein to build and repair muscle. And all the food groups provide vitamins and minerals that can help turn food into energy your body can use, build strong bones, and ward off infection.
Well, it amazes me how people seem to think that they have to find that special diet. They will watch their TV shows, go to the bookstore looking at books, not realizing that literally just eating healthy choices.
And there's so much out there,
exactly.
too.
Exactly. Yeah. And there's so many good recipes. And, of course, the dietitians.ca/eatwell is a great resource for that as well.
It's a great resource for recipes
And I want to talk about water, because I know that I think a lot of people can be very confused on water, thinking that they need to just be like drinking 8 gallons of water before they work out and drinking constantly. They've got their water bottle here the whole time. Is that true?
Well, we all need to drink water.
Right.
But you can overdo it. Some people have developed what's called, while dehydration is more common during exercise than drinking too much, on occasion some people have developed hyponatremia, which is low levels of sodium in the blood from drinking way too much. So I guess a safe game plan would just to be stay well hydrated every day by drinking 100% juice, water, milk and soy beverages, even tea and coffee and fruits count.
Right. Oh, and the fruit, of course, with its water content.
That's right.
As well.
Vegetables and fruit actually have quite a high water content. A lot of people don't realize, but food does contribute to your total fluid plan.
And one of the important things as well is I think people think with it being winter, because it's not boiling hot and you're not pouring sweat under a blazing sun, that you don't need to hydrate. But I know that's a big mistake I make when I'm out running. When it's hot, I'm drinking every time I feel I need it. When I run in the cold, I don't even bring water with me. And I'll be out for 2 hours without water, and that's obviously not something I should be doing.
Well, just think about it. You're wearing 3 or 4 layers of winter clothes, and then you have your hockey equipment on top of that, and you're moving around. So just because it's cold outside doesn't mean that you can catch the storm underneath all of that.
We know how that hockey equipment smells after a game.
Yeah.
No, you're sweating in
So always make sure that you have, even in cold conditions, you want to make sure that you have some water to sip. In cold conditions. So.
And we had talked in one of our earlier episodes this month, we had talked about fueling your body and how important it is to fuel your body. And again, that's something, so many people cut out carbs because they automatically assume all carbs are bad. But of course, healthy carbs are essential to fueling your body. But I think some people think that they can replace that just by downing a power drink on the way to the gym. And that will fuel their workout.
Right. No, and you know what? I've got some examples here of some really healthy snacks that can help that as well. 2 to 3 hours. If you're, protein supplements obviously are convenient,
right?
But can be very expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So again, following Canada's food guide and following the pattern outlined in there will obviously provide you with your carbohydrates and replenishing your protein to help build and repair muscle.
And I just wanted to quickly go over what some of the foods. These are some great examples of healthy snacks that aren't expensive, aren't hard to make. You can keep on hand. There's no excuse to not be using these.
Mm-hmm.
So what do we have here?
Well, I have here some, and these are great snack ideas after your workout to help replenish the fluid, as I mentioned before. And I have one example here is some almonds and an orange. an apple and some cheese. Mm-hmm. And my personal favorite is hummus and pita bread.
And I'm looking at these thinking, and I would also need my glass of wine with those.
And for some great meal ideas, you might want to try a great resource here to purchase, a Simply Great Food cookbook from Dietitians of Canada.
Well, it's some very great advice, and I think the best advice people can take is do not get caught up in the fads of diets, that you, as long as you're eating healthy food and making healthy choices with literally what's in the Canada's food guide, that's
exactly
really all you need.
Perfect.
Yep. Thank you very much, Linda.
Well, thank you, John.